John Wick Chapter 4 is a very good and very long movie. As the title implies, this is the fourth film in the series starring Keanu Reeves as the eponymous sad yet unstoppable killing machine. Allowing for David Leitch's uncredited work on the original film, all four movies in the series have been directed by former stuntman Chad Stahelski, who doubled for Keanu Reeves on all of the Matrix movies, and also appeared as a Chad named Chad in The Matrix Resurrections. All in all, the John Wick franchise serves as an affectionate love letter to the art of stunt work. At a time when modern blockbusters are increasingly dominated by empty computer-generated spectacle, the John Wick franchise understands the appeal of watching qualified stunt performers demonstrate their craft. Even at its lowest point, the John Wick franchise is consistently impressive and ambitious, a celebration of one of the unsung and oft-overlooked Hollywood art forms. Indeed, it's tempting to argue that everything in the John Wick franchise is secondary to Stahelski's confident action direction and the breathtaking choreography on display. For example, it's fair to complain that the previous film in the franchise, John Wick Chapter 3 Parabellum, ended pretty much exactly where it started, with the eponymous assassin alone and marginalized, hunted and on the run. John Wick always liked dogs, so it feels appropriate that he'd end up in a shaggy dog story. On the other hand, it's also fair to point out that Parabellum features a scene in which John Wick kills multiple people with a horse. So, naturally, mileage varies. It's to the credit of Chapter 4 that the latest entry in the franchise understands that this series is not a perpetual motion machine, and that audiences won't return forever to watch the titular assassin running in place. Throughout Chapter 4, characters are constantly asking John Wick what he thinks the end of this story is going to look like. He doesn't have an answer. The film clocks in at 2 hours and 49 minutes, which is over an hour longer than the original John Wick. It would be comforting to say that the movie doesn't feel its length, but that's not entirely the case. The film's opening 40 minutes or so are definitely a bit rough around the edges, simultaneously doing a lot of table clearing from the previous film and table setting for this one. However, once Chapter 4 kicks into high gear, it really gets moving. The film's second act feels like an update to the classic old-fashioned James Bond formula. A lavish travelogue, built around impressive action set pieces featuring suited men set against luxurious international backdrops like Osaka, Berlin, and Paris. Returning cinematographer Dan Lawston makes it all look glorious. The film's final hour is one of the best action set pieces in recent memory. It's been suggested that good artists borrow and great artists steal, and that crowd-pleasing filmmaking is largely about having good taste. Chapter 4 succeeds on both counts, with a finale that draws from a wide range of action classics, including older movies like Walter Hill's The Warriors, and newer films like Christopher McQuarrie's Mission Impossible Fallout. However, Chapter 4 also manages to find a strong thematic and emotional core. A large part of this is down to the new cast members, including Hiroyuki Sanada, who has the ability to enrich even the thinnest of roles, and action veteran Scott Adkins, who seems to be channeling his inner Colin Farrell. Still, allowing for all of these, the film's breakout new addition is Donnie Yen as the blind assassin Kane. As one might expect from Yen, Kane's action sequences are both inventive and playful. However, Yen also imbues the character with a rich inner life and complexity that makes him the best new arrival to the ensemble since Lawrence Fishburne and Common back in Chapter 2. Chapter 4 is both a little indulgent and a little clumsy in its storytelling, which mostly feels rooted in the shagginess of Parabellum. Watching the film, there's a feeling that the creative team really haven't left anything in the locker room, they brought it all to the mat. It is, at times, a bit much. However, it's also exhilarating and exciting, demonstrating an energy and enthusiasm sorely lacking from many similar franchises.
And Mr. Wick. Marhaba.
John Wick Chapter 4 is in cinemas from Friday, 24th March.